I was able to like watch a surgeon come in and do an emergency surgery, and I was just amazed. Like, that's when I was like, man, I want to go for surg tech instead of a nurse. Like, I want to be in the surgery and be a part of a team to help somebody get through.
For me, I was preparing for Afghanistan. I was with the Marines, and we had to learn how to give IVs, and that was interesting, but okay, I played along. But it came really evident when we were doing a patrol and one of the guys went down. I had to give him the IV. At that very second, it was very challenging, and I knew, oh my goodness, where's Doc? I didn't have a doc around. It was us. It was me and my four Afghan guys. And at that very second, after I gave him the IV and he came through, I knew, okay, this is what I want to do.
You know, John's case, he's a retired Marine, but he had a career already. But he wanted to go and do something different with his life, and so he came back to school. Cassie, very similar, although she didn't have a separate career. She had worked at several of the jobs, and then realizing that she wanted to further her education, and has a child and has a family. So those are big commitments those folks are making. And so I have a deep respect for them being, I don't know how they manage it all, to be honest. But I get motivated when I hear the stories by the students about what they're doing to show up every day. And that helps, that motivates me to show up every day and give my best effort.
The easiest way to sum up Professor Oliver is he cared. No ifs, ands, or buts. He really cares about his students. He wants you to understand the subject matter. Because in the end, for us and nurses and whatever medical field, sooner or later somebody might be looking up and they might see a student that they taught, and they want to make sure that student knows what they're doing.
Well, I remember going before class, oftentimes, and John would be leading a review session in the lecture room as I came in. And then Cassie would support him.
When I was in school before, I was learning just for me. Now I was learning for everybody in the class. And it started off with just Cassie and Themis. We had a great team. We were really solid. But everybody drove each other, not for their own personal goals, it was for the team goals. Can I help my partners get across the finish line? We're part of a team. The doctor has a huge responsibility, anesthesia, the nurses, everybody plays a part, and we have a part in this game.
And Lord Fairfax has been great for me. I mean, honestly, you know, I'm a single mom and I got financial aid. I didn't pay for anything and I got some money back to help me. I mean, I have an 8-year-old child and I work full time. So I'm working full time, going to school full time, trying to take care of him. And Lord Fairfax was great. I mean, they helped me, you know, pay for all my books, all my supplies.
When you go through Lord Fairfax, any higher education institution, you are going to be going out there with a piece of paper right off the bat. Wherever you walk into, you've got that piece of paper saying, I know how to do A, B, and C. But on top of that, it's not just that I know the body parts or whatever it may be, I can be taught. That's what a diploma does for you. It shows you that I've learned something, but it also shows the employer I'm willing to learn if you're willing to teach. So the employer, when they see a Lord Fairfax diploma or whatever diploma, they're going to see somebody that can be taught. And that's what matters.